This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle.
Everyone talks about how amazing the human brain is, but you know what gets no credit? The spine. Come on, spine, show some backbone. Hey there, my veritable vertebrates. Julian here for DNews. We've talked a lot on this show about how the human brain and how incredible it is. It's your own personal computer that can solve problems and feel love. It's basically what I hope Siri will be by the next iPhone. But the brain ain't nothing without the spine. It's your spine that sends the motor signals from your brain to your limbs so you can walk and pat yourself on the back. Thanks, spine. Sensory signals travel back from your spine to your brain so you can feel when you're getting a hug or a high five. Way to go, spine. The spine can even operate without the brain in some cases. The spine can store and learn reflexes. When the doctor makes your knee jerk or a hockey goalie catches a puck going 100 miles an hour, that's all spine, baby. Otherwise, it would take too much time for the brain to react and send the signals to the limbs, and the puck would be in the net. So, because the spine does so much more than just prop you upright, it's bad news when it gets damaged. The spine and the brain both exhibit neuroplasticity, meaning they can adapt and rewire themselves when they're injured. By the way, longtime viewers of the show know that when we say the word neuroplasticity, the DNews drinking game has begun. However, the spine's neuroplasticity is very limited compared to the brain's neuroplasticity. If the damage is severe enough, glial scars form that inhibit the regeneration of nerve fibers, or axons, and communication with the brain is cut off past that point. But there's been a breakthrough. Derek Fadika has been paralyzed from the chest down since being stabbed in 2010. Because our damaged central nervous system doesn't generate new axons, scientists basically hacked the human body to restore Fadika's spine. They took olfactory ensheathing glia, which stimulate the growth of olfactory axons in your nose, put them in his spine, and boom! After just 6 months of 5 hours of exercise and therapy 5 days a week, he can walk using leg braces and parallel bars. Okay, it's not instant gratification. In fact, it's a lot of very hard work that's physically and emotionally exhausting. But it's worth it just to be able to walk again. And to me, that guy's a hero. He's like Axon Jackson. So, if you can walk, don't take it for granted. Be grateful and hug a spine today with the spine owner's permission. What are some simple things your body does that you're grateful for? Like, I'm grateful to my liver every time we do a video involving neuroplasticity. Let us know in the comments, and thanks for watching DNews. Neuroplasticity.
This episode of DNews was brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle.